Can't go through with it.
But why? There's nothing to be afraid of.
What if those kids walk? I am a sitting duck.
Ruby, they will walk if you don't help to get them put behind bars.
But if I don't go to court and I don't testify, maybe they leave me alone.
I don't think that's true. I think they'll just go down the block and they'll rob somebody else. And how are you going to feel if you have that on your conscience?
Honey, when you've almost been killed and somebody put a gun to your head, you get a different perspective. Oh.
A gift. Hi, Bobby. Relax, it isn't loaded.
Bill, what are you doing with that?
It's a humanitarian gesture. These are the cold, hard realities.
I told you no once. I meant it. Now take that thing away.
Ruby, if things don't go well today, you're going to need this.
Bill might be right.
Look,
I don't want to kill anybody. And I don't want to die. I just want to be left.
Alone.
Look, Ruby, we understand that, but sometimes it's not our choice to make.
Well, while there's breath in this body, I will decide what I will do and what I won't do.
Did you happen to get one of these?
Yeah, just a thief.
Yeah? Well, I can tell you one thing you and I are both going to do, whether we want to or not.
What's that?
We're going to court.
Hey. Well, Dr. Hardy, maybe she went home first. Why don't you give her a call?
No, I think I'll wait a few more minutes.
Okay. Yes. All right. What is this?
A phone number?
It's Carl's. Yeah. You can call him and ask him out.
Come in. Shut up.
Oh, here she is.
Sorry, I'm late.
That's all right, Karen. Hi. All right, everybody, let's take our seats. Let's get started, okay? Our last session.
I'm going to miss you, Dr. Hardy. Are you going to hang out with us when the hotline opens?
Well, let me think about that. Of course I'm going to hang out with you. I'm not going to bail out. And listen, I have a surprise for you guys, but I'm going to wait till after our session's over today, okay?
Ooh. Oh, boy.
I can't believe we'll be handling our own calls tomorrow night.
Well, hotline calls won't all be serious problems. A lot of times kids will call in with complaints no worse than normal everyday stuff.
You mean like bad grades, Dr. Hardy?
There's something you'll know how to handle.
Oh, yeah.
Sure. Questions about boyfriends, you know, things like that.
Boyfriends? I might as well counsel someone on nuclear physics.
Chances are you may get more calls than anybody else on that.
No.
The thing is, though, they're equally important, especially to the caller. So who wants to try one today?
I will.
Robin, you create the problem. Carl, you take the call.
Hotline, what's up?
Hi, I'm really depressed, and I don't know what to do.
What's wrong?
Well, there's this really incredible guy, and I really want to call him up and ask him out on a date, but I'm afraid to make a fool of myself.
Are you friends with him?
Yeah, but I don't know if he feels the same way about me. I mean, he's really cute and really funny, but probably thinks I'm a jerk anyway.
Don't say that. Think positive. Who knows, maybe he's the jerk. You should find out.
Well, how do I do that?
Well, you had the nerve to call me. Go on, give him a call. Ask him out, see what he says. If he says no, don't waste your valuable time on him. He's not worth it.
You think so?
I know so. Just pick up the phone and say, what's his name?
No! I mean, no, don't give up. Call him.
Thank you, Jody. Carl's doing just fine.
His name is... Christopher.
Thank you. Yeah. Hotline, hi, I'm Jason. What do you want to talk about?
I have this friend who has a problem.
Well, can't you get your friend to call me?
No way.
Let me stop you for a moment there. Jody brought up a very common situation. A lot of times people will call and talk about themselves in the third person. It's easier to call and talk about a so-called friend than it is to admit that you have a personal problem.
But sometimes they might be telling the truth, can't they?
It's possible, Jody. Please continue.
I have this friend, Roberta, and she's in love with an older guy.
How old?
Oh, just 2 or 3 years. I've been trying to get her to get over him, but nothing I'm trying seems to work.
Huh. Well, that could be a problem. Well, how old is your friend?
14.
She thinks he's way out of her league.
Well, he's not married or anything, is he?
No, not that I know of. He's an upperclassman at school.
Well, that shouldn't be a big difference.
Well, he's also the most popular guy at school. I mean, all the girls follow him around, and he comes from a family that's really, really poor.
Well, I don't think that should be a big concern.
So you think there's hope for her?
Well, for a senior and a freshman to have a relationship, absolutely not. But if you want to tell me who you have a crush on, Jody, I might be able to try and fix you up with it.
Check it out. Excuse me, a television set. Do we have cable?
I'm afraid not, Carl. You see, you're going to be experiencing enough drama over the phones to last a lifetime.
Starting to hit home. We're not role-playing anymore, are we?
That's real life now.
Where's all the referral information?
Oh, all the 800 numbers you'll need are right here. Alcoholics Anonymous, AIDS counseling, runaway shelters, homeless housing, things like that.
Sounds like some pretty heavy stuff, Dr. Hardy.
Yeah, I hope we don't let you down.
You can't. You guys are going to do just fine. Now, remember, these kids are calling in. They don't want to talk to professionals. They want to talk to their peers. Now, whenever necessary, you can direct them to people who can really help them. I think you guys are going to do great.
I'm starting to get scared.
Let me let you in on a little secret. Even the best doctors get butterflies before surgery. We call it an edge. Use it, okay?
So what do you think? Maybe we can liven up this place a bit?
Sure. What do you suggest?
Oh, maybe some Nirvana posters.
Cool. I love that group. Great idea, Jody.
Really? Thanks. Did I tell you I could actually get tickets to their concerts?
You can.
Listen, you guys talk about what you want to do. I'm going to step out for a few minutes.
Get tickets?
Yeah.
I'm being pretty quiet tonight. You a little nervous about getting started?
No, not really. The whole purpose of this training session is to deal with real people, right?
Right. And I think you're going to be great. And there's something about you that makes me think you can really connect with people.
What's that supposed to mean?
I meant it was a compliment.
Oh.
These are yours.
No, they're not.
I meant I brought them for you, and they should help you out on your chemistry exams.
Oh, great. I can probably get them back to you in a couple days.
Well, actually, you can keep them as long as you want. I bought them for you.
No, Jason, I can't let you.
Look, it's no big deal. Come on, I have my own set. Really, keep them, please.
Well, then, let me pay you for them, please.
Why? They're a gift.
I'd just rather pay you for them. Thanks, Jason, really.